Hi everyone, and welcome to another TIA Portal tutorial. I apologize for the delay in uploading new video. In this video, I will talk about program control operations including jump and label, jump not, jump list, switch and return. Let's see how we can use these operations in TIA Portal. As you know, when a CPU is executing any program in an OOP, it will move from the top first network to the last network to scan the program from network 1 to the last one. This will be repeated over and over again. Sometimes we need to skip some networks and not let the CPU to scan what we have written in a specific network. In this case, we can use jump instruction. It's used to interrupt the execution of a program and resume the scan from another network. The destination network must be identified by a jump label. Here you see we have three networks. As long as M0.0 has a false value, as usual the first network will be executed, then the second one. The output Q01 will be true when M01 is true, and at the end the third network will be run. But if I activate the jump, the second network will not be scanned by the CPU, and if M01 even gets a true value, Q01 will not be on. Let's create this program in TIA Portal and see how jump instruction works. Open TIA Portal. From the instructions, open program control operations. You see here the jump instructions. Let me insert first a normally open contact here. Then we need a jump. It needs a label to jump to when it's activated. Currently it's red because we have not yet defined the label at any network. I will define it inside the third network. Second network with a contact and an assignment. Next network again a contact and an assignment, but I want to jump here when the jump instruction is activated. So I need to define a label in this network. Drag and drop label to the network. Write any name that you want, but it must be the same over the jump and here inside the label. Now when the contact in the first network has the signal state true, the jump here will be activated. So second network will be skipped and the program will be resumed from the last network. Let's go online and see the result. Initially M0.0 has a false value, so the jump is not executing. I can modify M0.1 to 1 and the output Q0.1 will be on. And third output can be also on. If I modify M0.0 to true, the jump will be on and the execution will jump to the third network. You see second network here is now light green. Even if I activate this contact, nothing will happen and the output will not be on because this network is not scanned anymore. The third network is working as usual. Now suppose this contact is already on before I activate the jump. M01 and Q01 are on. Let's activate the jump and see what happens. You see this network is again light green, but are the input and output now off? Let's see in a watch table. As you see, M01 and Q01 are both on. But as I said, this network is not executed anymore because of using jump operation. And we expected these variables to have a false value, but they are true. In this case, don't forget, when we use jump, a network will not be executed, but the variables inside this network will hold their last state. That's an important point using jump instructions. If I modify M01 to 0, Q01 will hold its last value, which is true. If I turn off the jump, now second network will be scanned again and the output will be off because the input is off. That is how jump works. Do not forget the specified jump label must be in the same block in which the instruction is executed. And also the name you specify can only occur once in the block. For example, we cannot use label 0 inside two networks. You see, both are now red, and if I compile the program, Tia will say the label must be unique. Okay, the second one is jump not. This is exactly the reverse of a jump. With jump, when we activate the instruction, the program scan will jump to the label. But with jump not, when the instruction is not activated, the execution is jumped to the label. Let's change the jump to jump not. Download the change. As you see, the contact is not true, but the jump not is active and the scan is jumped to label 0. The networks in between are not scanned. If I change the M0.0 to true, the jump will be deactivated. Next is similar to jump instruction. With the jump, we have just one jump and one label to jump to. But with the jump list, we have a list operation. Let's delete the jump and insert a jump list. In this case, we can choose which jump to be executed in our program using this input key. It means if the key is, for example, 0, the jump in destination 0 will be executed. With the key 1, the jump will be done to the destination 1 and with 2 to the destination 2. Define a variable for the key. Destination 0 is label 0. Let's create two new networks with a label. Add new label. Choose here the new label. Using this star sign, here we can add more destinations to the instruction. Start the simulation. Initially, the key is 0, so if I enable this instruction, jump to label 0 will be executed. The network 2 is not scanned now. Let's change the key to 1. Now jump 1 will be activated and all the networks before the label are not scanned and they become light green. Again, with the key 0, the networks 3 and 4 are back. We can define maximum 32 destinations. Be careful if the value of the key is greater than the number of destinations, the program execution will be resumed in the next network. For example, if we have two destinations but the key value is 3, then the next network will be executed. Now we have switch. It's similar to a jump list. Here we have also multiple program jumps, but each jump will be done depending on the result of a comparison in the input. So we have here an input to activate an instruction and an operand to compare and sum operators. You can select the comparison method for each individual input. Let me change the data type to an integer to see more operators. Add another label. If the first operator is true, I mean here if m worth 100 is equal to 10, the first jump will be activated. If it's less than 5, the second jump will be executed. As if the key has a value that is not less than 5 or equal to 10, the jump 3 will be activated. Like other instructions, we can define more jump destinations using this star here. Download the program. The key value is 0 and less than 5, so label 1 is active. Just networks 5 and 6 are scanned. Let's change the value to 10. Now jump to label 0 is active. And with 15, label 2 will be activated. That was how the switch works. We can specify which jump to be executed using some comparisons. The last instruction is return. We can use the return instruction to stop the execution of a program block. It means when return is activated, the program will be scanned from the top to the bottom. But when it reaches the network with return, it will stop scanning the program. The networks under this return will not be executed. If we use return in a function or function block, CPU will exit from FC or FB and will return to its previous block. I'm going to change the output of network 4 to a return. Here we can select the return value. We can define a variable and change it whenever we want or set it permanently true or false. Let me add a FC to see better how return value works. Call the FC. I'm going to activate the first return inside OB. You see the networks under return are not scanned. Even FC is not working, and when I change a variable, nothing happens. Now let's activate this return inside FC. Again, the network under return is not scanned. Here we can change the return value of this FC. As you see, enable output is now true. It can be used, for example, to say if the call of the FC was successful when the program execution reaches return instruction or not. Alright, that was a video about program control instructions in TR Portal. Hope this video was helpful for you. See you next video, friends. Bye.